Good morning, family and friends. How are you doing? I welcome you to this live broadcast and also to this beautiful day. So, I want to do something that is very important. And if you know me or you know anybody that know me, I want you to share this because I just want to do this today. Thus, this is the Bible. I'm going to tear it up. I can't set it on fire here. You know, this is the Living Bible. So, it's written right there. The Living Bible. I studied this Bible. The cover of it, I bought it in Nigeria because I want to come to America to show, you know, where I have network, how I used to study the Bible. You can see from back to back, every Bible I studied, you see, I was right. If you read my Bible, it will be like you attended Bible school. This is one of the Bibles I read, Genesis to Revelation. I never read Bible with a devotional book, whatever. No, I was studying the Bible by myself. You see, I studied this. So today, because we Africans supposed to know what Bible is, and when you know what African is, I mean what the Bible is, you treat it as it is. I use 3 pages of the Bible to wipe my ass after I used the toilet like a few minutes ago. The 3 places that really influenced my life: Isaiah 32, Isaiah 60, and Jude 1:24. So I make sure I use them to wipe my ass, and I saw the shit on them and throw them. So the reason why I cannot burn up this paper here is cold, and it's night here. There is smoke detector. You know, in America, every house must have smoke detector. So if I light it on here, boom, the smoke detector will go off, and you know what that is. So I don't want to do that, but I will tear it up. It's the same thing. In your Bible, it's written that Josiah, in 2 Kings chapter 23, verse 24, he destroyed. What did he destroy? Let me read it. Second Kings. Remember, you have to destroy all this magic book. Bible is a magic book. Quran is a magic book. And Torah, every religious book, the one your pastors have written, the one belonging to all of them, you have to destroy them. I remember when I give out, I rejected all the books I bought, both from Oyedepo, all the ministers I was following, or all the Christian books I've ever read. I discarded them because I don't need them. All right, so let me read to show you that you're supposed to do this. Those of you that believe in the Bible. Because you may say what I'm doing is not biblical, or you will expecting God to strike me or to do anything. No, fuck that God. I'm the one striking God. I'm the one trashing God, because it was man like me that made that God. God is a concept. Nobody has seen God. It's just an idea somebody came up with. So I'm doing this and I will keep sharing it. And if you want to encourage other people to do the same, to destroy all these they gave to us in Africa to keep us in bondage, which I'm about to read. 2 Kings chapter 23, verse 24. 23:24. Yes, I'm happy. All right, I've been sharing where Africans are burning Bibles, right? Some Quran and all that. Yesterday, somebody also inboxed me where Miss Ngozi, one of our daughters, one of our Igbo daughters, you know, where she ripped and burnt her own Bible, and she gave her testimony how Bible really influenced her negatively, because Bible have influenced Africans negatively, not positively. There's no positive thing that Bible brought to Africa, but slavery, evil, destruction. Like my last video that I made, I said religion is license to sin. It's Bible that gave us license to sin. You know, you lay hands on it and still rob the whole country. You lay hands on it and still hate people. You know people keep quoting Bible because Bible tell them you can commit sin and go for forgiveness. So it give you license to sin. In verse 24 of 2 Kings 23, it says, moreover, Josiah put away those who consulted mediums and spiritists. As you are consulting the pastors and all that today, the household gods and idols, the Bible. No African will tell me that the Bible is not their household god or their household idol. That's what the Bible has become to Africans. And if you talk any negative thing about the Bible, they get upset. They worship the Bible. They idolize the Bible. The Bible is holy. The Bible is living book. The Bible is everything God to them. You see, the Bible I'm about to tear up, he said, the living Bible. How about the living God? If God is alive, you don't need Bible. Bible has nothing to do with life. It was made from the tree, this book. There is no life in it. It cannot give anyone life. It is a mere book. You are in your house, you say you run out of toilet roll and you have Bible or Quran or Torah there. It's a paper that you can use them. Stop idolizing them. If you cannot tear your Bible up, you are idolizing it. If you cannot burn it, if you have to, you are idolizing it. If you feel bad that somebody is burning any religious book, whether it's Quran, Torah, or the Bible, you are idolizing them. It is my book. I bought it with my money. Or even if somebody gave it to me, it is my property. I can do with it as I want. If you can idolize it, I can trash it. It's mine. Abi, you're supposed to know that. So, this is my Bible. It's not your Bible. It's mine. I bought it with my money. It was not even a gift given to me. I bought it as an adult. So the same way I bought it, I can burn it, I can tear it, I can trash it, I can do whatever I want with it. I use it as a toilet paper few minutes ago to wipe my ass. You know what that means? And I said in 1993, I used, that was, you know, the small New Testament Bible they used to give to people where I was locked up. I used it to smoke weed. It's paper. It's nothing. And it's a good rizzler. To those of you that are rapping wheat, all right? So, he said, moreover, he put away those who consulted mediums and spiritists, the household gods and idols, all the abomination that we are seeing in the land of Judah and in Jerusalem. He put them away. He put away the idol. He destroyed the idols. If you read the story of Josiah in the Bible, you see how he destroyed all of them. It's time you destroy the foreign gods, the foreign idols they brought to Africa. If you believe your ancestors worship idols, you are a moron. Your African ancestors did not worship idols. Your African ancestors did not worship gods. Your African ancestors honored their gods and goddesses who were their ancestors. So why are we Africans leaving our own for another people? Some of you will say, but you are living in America. Of course, America is also our land. It's not white man's land. If you know, I used to think it's white man's land until I know the history. I say, I'm happy I'm in America, not like in Europe. Most part of Europe, do I say most? All the world belongs to Africa, if you know the history. So don't let anyone intimidate you, say, oh, you are in Malaysia, or you are in Europe, or in America, and you are talking. Of course, it doesn't matter where you are, you're saying the truth. The reason why you are where you are and not in Africa today is because of the wickedness of man. The evil they did in your own land, they turned your land as hellfire. and make their place as heaven. Who want to stay in hellfire? Who? So that's what Josiah did. He's talking about people burning Bible. Okay, let us see what the New Testament say about burning. Acts 19:19. Acts of the Apostles 19:19. Inye ha na neme hanwe buru na diswa. Acts 19:19. He said, also, many of those who had practiced magic, as I said, you have used Bible as magic book. You use it, you see how people use the Bible. I bind you, I cast you out. Or whatever, you know, they use the Bible to prophesy, they use the Bible to conjure, or to summon God, to summon help, to summon angels. They pray with the Psalms, all that. It's magic book. Bible is a magic book. And they said that those who practice magic brought their books. Those, all those religious book religions, they are practicing magic. That's where they believe their power is. Life is there. They go there to find maybe solution to their problem or to calm themselves down, because it's a magic book. Christians use the Bible as a magic book. Muslims use Quran as magic book. Jews people use Torah as magic book. Other religions that have books, their book is magic book. He said they brought their books together and burned them in the sight of all. They burned them. It's in your Bible. People burn their books, their religious books, their magic books. They burn them in the sight of all. So that's why I say destroy them without fear. Don't fear. No God will do anything to you. You see all this shit? This part of the cover. So this one is gone. I'll be putting it direct in a plastic bag so it don't litter all the floor. So this is it. As I've shown you this Bible before, you see, I wrote it right there. I said, Jesus' age is my age. For you to know how zealous without knowledge that I was as a preacher, as a Christian, as a believer. But today, you see, it's time you tear them. It's useless. It's not the word of God. There is no God anywhere that is almighty that can do anything for you. So it is time you practice what you preach. You say, practice what I preach, of course. You see? So, you it's your Bible. Don't let anyone tell you anything or God will do anything. This book has caused a lot of havoc in Africa. Among us, division. You see brothers hating brothers. African black people hating other black people because of Bible. You see black people accepting slavery because of the Bible. You see black people accepting to be Israelites. And accusing their own brothers, selling them into slavery because of Bible. This Bible brings division in families. It brings hatred among brethren. It brings confusion in lives of people. It is time you destroy it. Destroy them. Destroy those religious books without fear. No God will touch you. No God can curse you. No God will do anything good or bad to you. You're supposed to know that you are greater than any God people fear. You are greater than any God people worship. You are greater than any God people honor in any way. You're supposed to know that you are the living God if you are a man. You are the living goddess if you are a woman. And every religion of book is designed as a magic religion to deceive you, to lie to you, to make you accept what you are not. That's why you see many Christians today, grown adults, saying they are sheep. They are happy to be slaves of Jesus. No way. The truth shall prevail. And this is what we must be doing. We must trash every strange gods in our land, every strange idols in our land. Bible is a magic book. Don't regard it as the word of God anymore. Don't let anyone deceive you. When you see anyone preaching the Bible, they are out of their mind, especially if they are black people. They don't know the content of the Bible. They are just preaching what they were trained to preach. They went to Bible school. They went to Bible studies. They went, you know, today, you see, even in America here, I hardly see the Jews carry Torah as Africans carry the Bible. I live close to Jewish synagogue here, and when I'm going to work like Friday, Saturdays, you don't see them. You can see them wear their hat, their little hat, or I mean, some of them tie something around their waist and all that. But nah, I never see them carry Torah, carry books as Christians do, especially African Christians. The white people don't even carry the Bible as Christians do. Black Christians do. It's always black people. Every religion where you find black people, they are the true believers in that religion. They believe more than the founders of that religion. They can kill because they can kill their own loved ones. They can hate their own loved ones because of that religion. It is time we wake up. This is my Bible, and I have shredded them. You see how I tear them up? It is mine. Tell them. And you see all the characters they put in this Bible, these criminals, all of them are white. And I was reading this in Nigeria. White people as Jesus, white people as Moses, white people as the disciples of Jesus. Yet we read ourselves into it. A book that was written against us to keep us into slavery for life. And we are reading ourselves into it, and we are happy, thinking we know what we are doing. We don't know. My people, wake up, wake up, wake up. I shared a post a few minutes ago. I said, examine your pastors and your priests to know whether they are knowledgeable and sincere. Do they know the messiahs that existed before Jesus Christ? Where the churchmen copied the stories of Jesus from? Plagiarize them and sell to us as the truth why they are not. That's it. You see, I tear them off. All of them. It is not the word of God. This is just a paper. If it were then when I was selling akara with my mom, I can use it to wrap akara and sell to people. Alright? So this is just paper. It's a paper. It has nothing to do with any inspiration of God. No God exists to inspire any book. Have you seen the God that appeared and said, or come to the gathering of believers and said, yes, I gave you the Bible, or I gave you Torah, or I gave you Quran? It is people, somebody like you, who is smart, a fraudster, who decided to make up this to deceive you. And you still believing in them? No. See, it's the Bible. I shred it. You can do the same thing. You can tear your own. I tear it up because it's a weapon of mass deception and mass destruction. Why will you keep allowing the Bible or any religious book to keep destroying and deceiving your people? Now you are finding out the truth. Do it without fear. Destroy it. Destroy all those strange gods, those household idols. Bible is a household idol. The first thing my parents bought for me when I turned 12 was the Bible and the Bible as an Anglican member. My parents, they bought it. But I've been buying cell phone for my daughter is using iPhone 10 Max right now, while I'm using the iPhone 11 Max Pro. My daughter, she's 17. My father gave me the Bible. Yes, even at the age of, I think my father also bought me a new international version when I was like 18 or 19. It's a household idol. Bible is household idol, household God. It is time you destroy those idols. It was written by men, made by men. I'm encouraging you wherever you are. Don't be afraid. No God, no Jehovah, no Allah, no Yahweh can do you anything. It's the only people that can, or the only beings that can do you anything are Christians, Muslims, or Jews, because they are ignorant of what they are doing. Hating their loved ones, hating their fellow human beings because of imaginary being they have not seen, because of religion that is actually working against them. But no matter what, they cannot stop the truth from prevailing. I have turned my own Bible before you. You are next. Do it to show people there is no power in that Bible. There is no God of that Bible. There's no Jesus of that Bible. They are all lies designed to deceive and keep you in slavery for life. It is time you allow the factual truth to set you free and be bold about it. Peace.